Dear students, in the last video we have seen construction of similar triangles, triangles who were completely distinct. Today we are going to study construction of similar triangles which share a common vertex. So directly we start with an example today. Now if you see, we are supposed to construct these two triangles, and if you closely observe these triangles PQR and LTR, you see that they are not distinct triangles. If you see, they both share a common vertex, and who is their common vertex? R. Now triangle PQR is similar to triangle LTR. In triangle PQR, PQ, QR and PR measurements are given, and we are supposed to construct PQR also, and we are supposed to construct LTR also, such that PQ upon LT is equal to 3 upon 4. Now how do we start? Before starting, you must remember one thing. There are no such calculations involved in this construction, but you have to give a proper thought as to how to proceed. Now how do we start with? First of all, I start with the analysis. Because PQ upon LT is 3 upon 4, and as the two triangles are similar, so all the three ratios may be equal to 3 by 4. So what I do, I write PQ upon LT is equal to QR upon PR is equal to PR upon LR is equal to 3 upon 4. This information is given. After that, the first thing, as usual, we must draw an analytical figure. In the previous construction, there were two figures. Why there were two rough figures? Because they were two separate triangles. Why there is just one figure here? If you see, there are two triangles involved in the same triangle. If you see PQR and LTR, there are two triangles, but they share a common vertex R. Now, how do you know that PQR is a smaller triangle and LTR is a bigger triangle? Just observe the ratio PQ upon LT. If you see the ratio PQ upon LT, you get it as 3 by 4. It means PQR is a smaller triangle and LTR is a bigger triangle. So what did I do here? LTR and PQR. So the most important thing is first analyzing the ratio and drawing the rough diagram. After you finish with the rough diagram, now actually we start with the construction. So now, which triangle can we construct from this given information? I can construct triangle PQR. So the first thing I am going to do is construct triangle PQR. Okay, so let's proceed and construct triangle PQR. So let me construct triangle PQR. Now, if you see in the analytical figure PQR, P2 is given as 4.2 cm. QR is given as 5.4 cm. And PR is given as 4.8 cm. So I wrote down this in the rough figure, and now I start with the actual construction. So the first thing, as usual, I am just going to construct this triangle because I know the measures of this triangle only. So now I begin. First I draw the base. So I draw the base RQ. So what is the length of RQ given as? RQ is given as 5.4 cm. Now, you all will ask, teacher, is this the way to name the triangle always? You can name it in any way, but the most convenient way is getting the common vertex down somewhere, either on the left or on the right. So, if you see the common vertex shared by both the triangles R, so conveniently I have placed R on this side. Now, from R to P, the distance is 4.8 cm. So, what do I do? With the help of a compass and scale, I measure 4.8 cm and I just draw an R. After that, if you see, QP distance is given as 4.2 cm. So, with the same distance, 4.2 cm, I place the point in here and I just draw an Now, your trigon is ready. Which trigon is ready? PQR with RP as 4.8 cm and PQ as 4.2 cm. Now, after constructing trigon PQR, we are supposed to start with trigon LPR. Now, how do I begin? Now, who is the common vertex in both the triangles? R is the common vertex. So, with the help of your protractor, take any acute angle and just draw a ray. In this measure, anything that you want, preferably less than 90, and then just draw this ray. After that, you see, from 3 and 4, who is the greater, who is the greater number 4? So, just take convenient distance with the help of your compass and mark arcs. So, this is 1, 2, 3 and 4. So, what did I do? From the common vertex, I drew an acute angle of any measure you want. And from the ratio, I must see a bigger number. Is 3 parts greater or 4 parts greater? 4 parts is greater. So, as we saw that 4 is a greater number, so what I do? From R to R1, I take convenient distance with the help of compass and I mark the first arc. And now keeping the same distance, keeping the distance constant, now I start marking from R1, R2, R3 and R4. So what have I done? From R to R1, R1 to R2, R2 to R3, R3 to R4, I have marked equidistant points. So R1, R2, R3, R4. Now again we have to look at the ratio. Now if you see, PQ is 3 parts, LP is 4 parts. We also had another ratio. What was it? Another ratio, say QR upon TR as well as TR upon LR. That ratio was 3 upon 4. So now how do I start? Now if you see, QR is 3 parts. So what I have to do here, this R3, with the help of your measure, with the help of your scale, just join QR 3 parts thickness, I should join Q with R3, just using scale and pencil. Now, what I have to do, I have to consider such an angle here. Now, how do I do that? If you remember the basic construction, last construction, how we have done, construct an angle congruent to the given angle. So the same step we have to follow and construct such an angle here so that because the corresponding angles will be equal, I can draw a line parallel to this. So now how do I start? Because the triangle is a bigger triangle, I will have to extend this. Now with the help of your compass, you take any convenient distance, place the pointer here and draw an arc. Now, keeping the same distance, now place the pointer of your compass on R4 and draw an arc. Now, just see what the distance is there between these two arms. Measure this distance and keeping the same distance with the help of your compass, place your pointer and just cut this arc. So, see for example, the arc is cut here. Now, what do I do? I just join this and this point. And after joining, I just try to see whether the lines are parallel. So here I have drawn a line parallel to this. Now again, what we have to do? After this step, you just have to just extend this. And now, such an angle, you are supposed to construct at this point. Now how do I do that? Again, I follow the same steps. I take convenient and I draw an arc, placing the pointer on Q. Now keeping the same distance, I place the pointer on this point and I draw an arc. Now I measure what the distance is between the two arms, this distance, and now I place the pointer of the compass here and I just cut this arc. Now I just join this point and this point till here. Now, this is PQR, and if you see in the analytical figure, this point is L, this point is T, and this point is R. So now I have constructed two triangles PQR and LTR whose sides share a ratio 3 upon 4. So just verify RQ, if it is taking 3 parts, RT is taking 4 parts. So this is how you proceed with the construction. Now after this sum, we will practice one more sum so that the concept becomes clear. So now we proceed to the next sum. Now we start with the next example. Say it is of the same kind, just a minor difference. Now triangle AMT is similar to triangle AHT. Triangle AMT is similar to triangle AHT. In triangle AMT, AM is 6.3 cm, angle TAM is 50 degrees, AT is 5.6 cm, the ratio is given as 7 upon 5 and we are supposed to construct triangle AHE. Now even though they have written down to construct triangle AHE, but we have to construct triangle AMT also. Now before we start with the analysis, first let me write down, they already had given AM upon AH as 7 upon 5. What did I do? I wrote down all the three ratios equal to 7 upon 5 because they are corresponding sides of similar triangle. Now again see, observe the two triangles and observe the ratio. Now if you see AM upon AH 7 upon 5, it means AMT is a bigger triangle and AHE is a smaller triangle. So in the analytical figure, I drew AMT as an outer bigger triangle and AHT as the inner triangle. I have to make this analytical figure based on this ratio. Because 7 is greater here, I understand AMT is a bigger triangle and AHT is a smaller triangle. And as I told you, they both share a common vertex A. So what I did for my convenience, I adjusted the names in such a way that either it can come on this side or on the other side, anyway it is okay. So I wrote it on this side. Now let me write down the measures. So now I know the measures of triangle AMT. So now if you see, AM is given as 6.3 centimeters. This entire thing is given as 6.3 centimeters. Just see what else is given. Angle TAM is given as 50 degrees. TAM is given as 50 degrees and AT is given as 5.6 centimeters. So this entire length is given as 5.6 centimeters. In the previous example, we were constructing first the inner triangle and then we constructed the outer triangle. Now in this case, we are going to draw the bigger triangle first. Why we are going to draw the bigger triangle first? Because the measures of the bigger triangle are given and then we will draw the second triangle inside the first triangle. So now I start construction of triangle AMT. So how do I proceed? First of all, I draw the base. What is the base given as? 5.6 centimeters. So first I draw AT as 5.6 centimeters. Then I see angle AMT or angle MAT is given as 50 degrees. So with the help of your protractor, we draw an angle of 50 degrees. Then I take AM as 6.3 centimeters. So from here, I take the measure as 6.3 cm and I draw an R and then just I join this. So this is how you do the basic construction of a triangle. So this is your triangle AMT. So what I did, because AMT measures were given, I drew triangle AMT first. Now what we did in the previous sum, from the common vertex we drew an acute angle the same way. If A is the common vertex, so what do I do from A? I draw an angle of any measure. A2, A3, A4, A5, A6 and A7. Again I look at the ratio here. Now if I look at the ratio, if you all see 7 parts. So if you see 8, 7. So with this T, I have to join A7. So with this T, I have to just join with the help of the scale and pencil. I will join this T at A7. Now I have to construct this angle at A5. So how do I proceed? Take any distance with the help of your compass and just draw an arc here. Say this is the arc. Now keeping the pointer on A5, again what I do? I draw an arc. So at A5 with the same distance, I draw an arc. Now just see what the distance is between this point and this point. Just see what this distance is. And with the help of your compass, just place the pointer there and cut the previous arc. Now this A5, with the same, what you do, just try to measure this distance and with the same distance place a pointer here and cut here. And now join this A5 with this point. Just join it. Okay. Now what do I do next? Now such an angle I construct at this point. So how do we do that? Take any convenient distance with the help of your compass and draw an arc here. Placing the same, keeping the same distance and placing the pointer here. Again, draw the arc of the same measure. Then try to see what the distance is between the two arms of the angle. And now placing the same distance here, just cut this arc and now join this point of intersection and this point. Just join it in here. Now how do I name it? Just see, you can look into the analytical diagram. This is A and T. And now what I have drawn? A, H, E. So this was the required triangle. So this way we have to solve the sums of constructing similar triangles with common vertex. Now these sums are important. Most they are more probable to come for 4 marks. So more practice is needed, more understanding is needed, more proper observation of the ratios is needed so that you understand which triangle is out, which triangle is inside. And you have to see that these lines are parallel lines. Only if the lines are parallel, the triangles are going to become similar. So this is how we learn how to construct similar triangles. So this is all for today, and in the next video we will be seeing construction of tangents. So the next video we are coming up with construction of tangents, and this is all